Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. This is your science lecture of grade 5th, and I am your science teacher Aparna Pandey from Arjun Progressive School, Lamachur. So students, as you all know that soon our exams are going to start, so we have started revision of the chapters that we have done till now. So in this series, revision number 1, that is related to growing plants from seeds to seedlings, that we have done. Now today I have brought some key points, some important things related to the chapter number 2. So we are going to revise now chapter number 2, and its name is Varying Lifestyles of Animals. See, here I have just written the revision number 2. Here I have mentioned just revision number 2, but this revision is related to the chapter number 2, Varying Lifestyles of Animals. Now beta, here let's revise first. As you know that in this chapter the topics are divided according to their feeding habits, according to the movements done by the animals, and then according to the way they migrate. So first of all, in today's class we are going to cover feeding in animals topic. Okay, in today's class we are going to revise first feeding in animals. So beta, when we talk about the feeding in animals, now you all know very clearly that we can divide the feeding habits of animals mainly into the three categories, and these are herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, right? The main three category in which we can divide the feeding habits of animals are herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. Then there are some different types of habits that we see, like proboscis. Similarly, then some have the sticky tongue. Similarly, then some have piercing and sucking nature. So this all we are going to discuss. Now let's start. So see, first is, I have written here herbivores. So what are herbivores? You know very well, animals, those who eat plant and grass, they are called the herbivores. So what I have written, that herbivores animals have sharp front teeth and strong broad fin. Okay, sharp front teeth to bite and a strong broad teeth so that they can chew the plants and trees, whatever they have taken as their food. Then the example of the herbivores animals are cow, goat, sheep, horse, giraffe, etc. Right? I think this is clear to everyone. Herbivores are the animals, those who eat plants and trees. Here they have sharp front teeth, they have strong broad teeth. Sharp front teeth are used for the bite, taking bite, and the strong broad teeth are there to chew. Then examples, cow, goat, sheep, horse, giraffe. Let's talk about the carnivores. Carnivores are the another category of the animals in which we say according to their feeding habits. So the carnivores are the flesh eating animals. These are the animals, those who eat flesh of some other animal. So they have sharp, pointed and curved teeth. Carnivore animals have sharp, pointed and curved teeth so that they can easily pierce the flesh and can chew it properly. These are the properties of the carnivore animals, and the example of carnivore animals are lion, tiger, cat, etc. Right? Let's talk about the third category, that is omnivores. What are omnivores? Omnivores are the animals, those who eat both plant as well as flesh. When we talk about the omnivores animals are those animals who eat plant as well as flesh. So what I have written, omnivores eat both plant and animals, and the example, those who come in this are jackal, deer, crow. These are the example of the omnivores animals. Now student, you can see that I have written here proboscis. What is this proboscis? Earlier also I have explained you in the video that proboscis is a type of a sucking way of taking food. Proboscis is a type of a sucking way of taking food. So this habit is used by some insects like butterflies and honeybees. Insects like butterflies and honeybees have mouth part for sucking, and the process is called proboscis, and the method by which they suck, this is called proboscis. Then when we talk about the sucking habit, then one more is there that is most common, and you have seen these days in your homes also, and it is mosquito. Mosquito has a habit of piercing as well as sucking. Mosquito has a habit of piercing as well as sucking. So when we say about the habit of the mosquito, then we can say that it has piercing as well as sucking habit. Now, piercing, have you heard, have you felt that as a mosquito comes, it pierces, then you feel that, oh, something happened, and then suddenly it sucks. That's why there is a swollen area is there on your skin, right? So this habit is, this method is used by the mosquito for feeding. Okay, then another thing we can see that there are some animals, those who swallow their prey. Swallow their prey means just take the whole prey inside. They instead of chewing, they just swallow their prey. So what are these? Let's see. Here I have an example of crocodile and snake. So crocodile and snake are the example of such animals, those who have feeding habit of swallowing. Those who have feeding habit of swallowing. Prey means the one which they eat. So that is called a prey. So swallow prey is the habit of crocodile and snake. Crocodile and snake swallow their prey, right? Then we have some rodents. We have some rodents. What are these rodents? See, the rodents are the animals, those who have habit of new seeds and fruits. Means they just eat the seeds and fruits. And the example of this is rat, rabbit, squirrel. They just eat the seeds and fruits. So these are the rodents. And then we have birds. Do you know what are the feeding habit of birds? How birds feed? So beta, birds have beaks and claws. Birds have beaks and claws, and these both things help them in taking food. With the help of the claws, they catch their prey, and with the help of a beak, they eat. So feeding habit of birds, birds take their food by with the help of a beak and claws, and the birds who have a very sharp claws and beaks, these are like eagles, vultures and birds. Okay, these are like eagles, vultures and birds. So I hope feeding habit in animals is clear to you now. I have told you we have three types of animals, mainly herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. Then I have told you about one habit called proboscis, then piercing and sucking method. Then we have swallow prey. There are some animals, those who swallow their prey directly. And one is left, that is there is one animal who is having a sticky tongue. Sticky tongue, and with the help of that sticky tongue, the prey of that animal attach on its string, and then he eat them very easily. So what is the name of that animal? It is frog. Frog is an amphibian who lives both in water as well as in land, and it has a sticky tongue. With the help of its sticky tongue, frog take its prey and eat it very easily. Now, when another thing that we talk related to this chapter, then that is the movement in animals.
Movement. M-O-V-E-M-E-N-T. Movement in animals. So, student, do you know that for movement, animals have specific organs, right?
With the help of which they do movements, like they have legs, they have hands, that's why they are able to run, they are able to climb, they are able to hold the thing. So how these all things are done? These all things are done with the help of a legs. These all things are done with the help of a limbs. L-I-M-B-S, limbs. What are these limbs then?
What are these limbs?
Limbs can be divided into two types. Limbs can be divided into two types. Fore limb and hind limb. Limbs can be divided into the two types. Fore limb and hind limb.
F-O-R-E, only, and H-I-N-D, finally.
What are these four legged finally? See, I told you that for making movement, for doing our work, we have hands and legs. If we want to run, we make use of legs. If we want to walk, we make use of legs. If we want to climb, we make use of legs. Similarly, animals use both their hands as well as legs for the movements. As well as they use their hands for some other purposes also. For picking up the food, for climbing and many other things they do with the help of the hands and legs both. So actually, what are these? These hands and legs are our body parts. These are the body parts of animals which are called limbs. Which are called limbs. So when we talk about the limbs, we can categorize limbs into the two parts, and these are forelimbs and hind limbs. And these are forelimbs and hind limbs. Now what are forelimbs? So student, limbs which are in front, they are called forelimbs. And the limbs which are in back side are called the hind limbs. I told you that limbs are there, and limbs are the body parts. These are of two types, forelimb and hind limb. Forelimbs are the limbs which are in the front side, and we can also call them as hand. And hind limbs are the limbs which are in the back side, and we can also call them legs. When we talk about the human beings, then we can say hands as a forelimbs and we can say legs as a hind limbs. And when we are talking about the animals, animals have four limbs. I hope you have seen two limbs in the front side and two limbs in the back side. So front side limbs are called the forelimbs and back side limbs are called the hind limbs. So student, I hope now this much is clear to everyone. Whatever the topics I have discussed in this today's class, it is clear to everyone. I hope this video will help you in revising chapter number 2 topics that we have discussed today. I hope you all will like this video. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.